Hello, I'm Steve, the Touch of the Master's Hand, Holy Spirit Ministries. I'm going to kind of politicize or bring into politics Jesus today, kind of in light of what's everything's happened. That's why I titled this message. You know, what would Jesus think of this current political situation, this and that, and the media, and all the crap that they portray and lie? They base it upon fear, and they base it upon hatred and racial stuff. You know, I mean, current politics, you know, I'm sorry, General Kelly, but there was nothing honorable about General Lee and his actions. It was based upon a society, his beliefs and what he was fighting for was based upon a society, a group, states. It was all based upon greed, economics of greed. They were going to enslave a whole race of people just to get their way, to get their greed, to make extra money, to make more money. And they didn't care. Murder was probably a part of it. Rape was probably a part of it. They treated those people horribly, a whole class of people. And I'm not going to jump on the bandwagon of racism like the media does. I'm not racist. I'm 55, white, and I'm not racist. 9 years of my first Christian experience and walk with Jesus was all under Black Ministries. I was saved, brought to the Lord, accepted Jesus in my heart under a Black minister named Odell Miller. Spent time under a Black minister named Van Dyke B. Howard. Spent 6 years under a Black minister named Nathaniel Dorsey. And you know what? Racism never entered in. I was just glad to be saved from a drug-infested life of running from the law, dealing drugs, and everything kind of train wreck that you can think of that was behind it. He wasn't racist either. Never once did he preach a racist message. He just preached about Jesus. He preached about Christ in you, the hope of glory. He preached about when you see us, you'll see Jesus. That's what we need to interject into this world. It's a heart issue, you know? It's a change of heart. That's what this world needs. That's what America needs, a change of heart. And then there wouldn't be all this crap, you know? I can kind of get it where some of these where people are really mad about some of the statues and the portraying of, you know, as General Kelly put it, honorable. There's nothing honorable about it. It's a dark, dark, dark time in American history. Horrible, evil time. You know, a hatred time. And, you know, like I said, the media portrays the more fear that's involved in it, the more racism that's involved in it, the division that's involved in it. You know, there is a lot of lies mixed in with some truth. You know, so that's what they're trying to portray in this world. You know, there's millions of people that aren't racist in this country. You know, get off of it, media. Get off of it, you know, the political realm of everything that's just hatred. You know, Jesus said he did not give us a spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind. You know, read the Bible for yourself. That's what this is all about. I'm not going to get off of it. There's ungodly laws that have been passed that have been shoved down our throats. You know, abortion being one of them. Yes, it is murder. But we throw those poor women under the bus. Where's the church to try to help them out? It's about education and economics. They are backed into a corner. Feel like they have no choice in the matter. Let's reach the ones that we can reach. We're not going to stop them all. Quit carrying a placard and do something about it. A sign that says that calls it what it is, you know. Help these poor women. There's a church denomination that I'm not going to name, that, you know, will say things like having a personal relationship with Jesus is dangerous. There's other denominations, and I'm not just picking on denominations. There's charismatic movements too that just, you know, heard they had 28,000 members. Well, what if they each gave $10 towards helping these poor women that had the choice between abortion or economic collapse of their world? You know, no education, no future for a job, getting a $10 an hour job. Can you imagine trying to make it on $10 an hour? Anyhow, Jesus needs to be at the center. Look at some of my other videos about Jesus at the center, the election video, Jesus at the center. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. That was God's plan for the salvation of mankind, was Jesus. You know, people talk about God, and we say that we're a God-fearing nation. 90% of us say we're a God-fearing nation. You talk about Jesus, and people scatter and run. But that was God's plan for the salvation of mankind, was Jesus. We need to interject Jesus in it, a heart changing, accepting Jesus as your personal Savior, changing your heart, and it'll change the politics and the landscape of this country. Instead of all this racial division and all this hatred that's being spewed out and all this fear that's being spewed out, you know, no wonder people say the media is lying. They're just twisting it up, because that's what sells news, is all this crap that they're portraying this country to be. It's time for Christians to stand, portray Jesus, so when people do see us, they do see Jesus. They see the love of Jesus portrayed in our hearts, out of our hearts. It's time to reach people for Christ. We're living in the grace dispensation. Look at my message about economic collapse. Look about at my other messages. I'm not the only one preaching this truth. I'm not saying that I'm, you know, 90% of what I'm saying is true. I still miss it some. I got to repent, change my tune, change my attitude, change everything about it. Sorry, I'm going to try to cut this message short. I really didn't want to go past 5 minutes. So anyhow, you know, I'm sure I'll get some hate mail. I'm sure I'll get some vulgar comments and all kinds of crap. I don't really care. I'm going to preach the truth about Jesus, and that's what we're living in, and it's time for people to change their hearts and accept Jesus into their heart, and then watch the world change. So anyhow, that's my message. I'm not going to get off of it. Look at some of my other videos, post comments. You know, there's a cool book that I wrote that Jesus inspired me to write about visions. You can get a free copy. Just look at my other videos, post them on other websites, talk to your friends about it. Just appreciate your help. Thank you for helping me get this message out. God bless you. See you soon.